Hey, Tate here. Today we're taking a look at technical analysis for natural gas. I'll cover wave analysis with the elliptic wave theory and provide multiple scenarios a price may take and explain why I prefer one count over another. Let's take a look at the different possibilities. Starting here on daily time frame, we've had this trend line on RSI pivoted from the highs of around the 18th of April to the 7th of June highs. Again, currently now retesting this trend line as a resistance, and we'll see if it can puncture through or just roll over again downwards. Overall, we have two different scenarios. One is saying that we have the bottom here, or a bottom here, and the other one is saying that we are correcting a part of this structure over here, so something like this. But we'll see and look into this options in just a moment. Overall, the lowest RSI is down here, so we could be using this as a third of something, which we have done. This is one of the counts that are saying still that we have more downside to go to, and in this one we have 1, 2, and this whole structure here would be a 3, then looking for this wave 4 and then 5. Now we'll look into this more, or this structure more, in just a bit, but for now it definitely looks more like a 5-way structure and not a 3-way structure. We have already gone back to this previous wave 4 area, in which we are expecting this higher time frame, or this higher time frame wave 4 to go to, and let's actually measure how much we had the retracement of this as well. Well, currently right now it is around that 38.2%, which is again the very expected value. 0.5 is right beyond the previous wave 4 here. Didn't have it correctly placed there. So right there, something like this. And yeah, that looks pretty nice as is. Although we don't have that good looking structure in here that would support this idea of being a 3-way structure though. Now, still looking good overall. However, we are getting bearish divergence here on these highs, so we have to acknowledge that, and that would have some kind of bearish pressure downwards. Then we have other scenarios in which we have already created a bottom here. This one is saying that we have a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 here. The third here would not really have too much of a divergence between the fifth at all. Again, this third here was a weak, so we can't really say too much about that as is. The weak, or the RSI, is based on the close of the candle. Maybe we can see some kind of, yeah, there is a very slight divergence here between this, at least on 2 hour, we can see it from these lows. Again, better divergences in these lows between the third and fifth. Of course, this is not very nice looking structure here. This is very messy structure in here into the fifth as well. And trying to even get a 5-way structure in here is very bad. I just can't get anything else out of it. If I want to be saying that this is indeed an impulsive structure, I would have to say this is a fourth and this the fifth. I can't get this structure anymore worked into this count, as it is taking so much more time than anything else. Also, I can't really get this as a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I can't really say that this is a fourth and fifth comparing it to this whole structure overall. It just doesn't make too much sense structure wise. Otherwise, if we had a wave 4, something even like that, then we could be calling this as an A, B, and this would be C. And then we could be calling a wave 4 there on that higher time frame, or on the other count at least. But at the moment, this to me looks like it is somewhat finished down here, as we have created somewhat good looking structure in here as a 5-wave structure. And again, this we have to remind that, again, if this is indeed a 5-way structure, we have to be knowing that as we are correcting something downwards, then we have this as a B and C structure. So again, we would be expecting higher retracement here. But yeah, that is that. One more scenario here, which is suggesting the same thing, having this as the end here. In this one, ABC, three ways again X, and then very elongated ABC here is looking nice as well, although I don't like how small the X wave here is. That's why I kind of prefer these ideas more, these impulsive wave structures. But again, this is possibility. What makes these a bit different to each other is that the WXY has a possibility of completing a whole correction of something that we were correcting before it. So if we are looking at higher time frames, we could be correcting, for example, the whole structure of this. Overall, did I have some structure in here? There. For example, this one. We could be saying that we have completed 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 into wave 1, and now we'd be completing a wave 2 with the WXY structure coming downwards. So it is very good looking overall, and probably is around that golden pocket as well. Not quite there, but yeah, more than 50% retracement. So we could definitely say that wave 2 is in here if we are looking at this count. But again, let's focus more on the current structures that we had here. So local, whether we like this being A or something else, this looks the best at the moment for me. This as a wave 1, then wave 2, some kind of three-way structure, a most likely a flat pattern here. And then again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 in here for the third. We do have the highest RSI here as well, which would support it. Let's take a look at the volume here as well. It is supporting the idea as well, having the highest volume here on the top of wave 3, then some kind of three-way structure downwards, having this massive gap here onto the first of the fifth. I'm not quite sure if the fifth is done here though, as we have reached the highest RSI here on a smaller time frame. So to me, this could be a 1, 2, and then this would be a 3 and 4, whatever this forms out to be, as we have that highest RSI here. That's why I'm not shorting this as of yet. I would like to see a divergent form between these highs and creating a lower low here on RSI to get that nice bearish divergence, regular divergence, and then we could be looking at price declination downwards. Now, I'm not expecting too much out of this, although the wave 3, if this is indeed that wave 3, it is kind of small. It is kind of small compared to the previous wave structure here. If we are starting it from here, and this is indeed wave 2. Wave 2 is very shallow, so it would be in order to expect that wave 1 is very sharp and very deep, as wave 2 was very sideways and very short, at least in price terms, right? So that would be the expectation. At the moment, can't really say anything about it yet. It is so recent. Very bullish momentum here. We did have this pump up into this. And let's see. Well, we could be saying that this is a 1, 2. So again, fifth is definitely not here, I don't think. At least not my expectation for it. Now let's make sure that we have some targets for the wave 5. Wave 3 is not too extended, so we could be expecting that extension. To me, if the wave 3 is going beyond the 2.618, then we can call it extended. If not, then it is not really extended. But again, none of the waves need to be extending, but generally one of them are. So what we can do is measure the targets here for the possible wave 5. Wave 5 not extended, and then put the right collar, and this should be on the left side and right collar. There we go. And there it is. So this should be as well a purple collar, as that is going to be a possible 1, 2, whether the 3 is done or not. If it is, then we are expecting an extension here on the 5th wave for sure. And then we could be expecting this 1-to-1 on higher time frame. Again, the 0.618 of this 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 is the first target we want to see. We are not there yet. We're very close to it. But again, I have my alert set. If we are going to puncture it and looking downwards, I can update people at least on the Discord, if nothing else. But yeah, that is pretty much my expectations on natural gas and the very short time frame. Structures and things to come. If you made it this far into the video, I would appreciate the likes on the video and link to my free Discord server in the description below. Please let me know what asset should I cover next, and yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next video as well. Bye bye.